Well, tonight, a Western Wisconsin community is coming together for a dairy farmer. He's fighting for his life right now. Adam Hedlund got COVID last October, and since then, it's been both a battle for him in the hospital and for his family at home. Megan Reistad brings us to a benefit tonight in Frederick, Wisconsin.
A seat is open at Annie Hedlund's picnic table. It's a spot supposed to be filled by her husband.
Nice one of Adam.
But Saturday night, this park in Frederick, Wisconsin, is full of love for a wife and mom just trying to hold on.
We need him home. We need daddy home.
A benefit for Annie's husband, Adam, still hospitalized after getting COVID last October.
The doctors don't know how he is still alive.
Two lung transplants later, he's still trying to get off a ventilator. The Hedlunds are dairy farmers, so Adam's absence is felt at home and on the farm.
It's myself and another girl that milks cows usually. And then Adam used to do all the feeding and crops and all that. So when he got sick, his dad kind of came out of retirement and had friends and family, you know, chip in.
Adam is at a hospital in Milwaukee. So between dairy farming and the distance from home, his family hasn't been able to visit as often as they'd like.
He was born May 9th, and he's seen him twice.
Initially, organizers were planning for about 200 people, but soon word got out, so they bumped that number up to 300. And based on raffle ticket sales and just how much food has been served, they're thinking about 350 people have showed up in support.
We're running out of food. I've been to Dollar General twice already.
Lori Lundquist is a neighbor and remembers the day Adam was born.
40 years ago today.
A special day. Both Adam's benefit and his 40th birthday celebration.
It's hard to even thank everybody, you know. I don't know what you're supposed to do.
And Annie is at a loss for words.
For all the people that have helped us.
Just thankful for so many who've showed up when she needed it most.
Like I said, it's been really overwhelming.
In Frederick, Megan Reistad, Care 11 News.
Oh, we're thinking of that family tonight. We do have some good news. Annie is making a trip to Milwaukee this week to go see Adam. All of the food, silent auction items, and raffle prizes at tonight's benefit were donated by businesses or people in the community. If you would like more information on how you can help, and maybe you just want to follow Adam's story, we have a link to all this information on care11.com.